Hi, folks. Welcome back. Mark O'Mara, you know him most prominently, of course, for the George Zimmerman case, where he defended George Zimmerman. And, of course, he's become a wonderful CNN legal analyst. He's also still active, of course, as an attorney, and he's become involved in a self-defense shooting case in Eugene, Oregon. And it's the case of Gerald Strebent, I hope I'm pronouncing it right, a former Marine sniper and a retired professional mixed martial artist, MMA. And it's a bizarre situation, and Mark can't talk a lot about it, and he'll tell you why, which adds to the bizarreness of the situation and really addresses why it's so bizarre. But we welcome in Mark O'Mara. Mark, welcome, and tell us what's going on here that makes this so unusual.
Well, you know, the facts of the case itself is sort of interesting, because here you have a Marine sniper who, you know, you first say those words and you think somebody who just knows how to kill people. But the reality is, you look into it, snipers are trained not to shoot unless they need to and have to. So there's those facts that are out there. It was a road rage incident where my guy was on 911 call trying to get the cops there before the shooting. But the more unique part about it, and that's what I have to be a little bit cautious to speak about, is the judge has entered a gag order that truly limits a lot of what can be said about the case and even keeps a lot of the documents of the case private or confidential. So I can't talk much about that. Well, you know, I'm part of the helping out the defense. We're gonna respect that order.
But why, Mark? Place. Why would I mean, as a layman who thinks that if I ever did had chosen to become a lawyer, I might have made a decent one. Why? I mean, why? How unusual is this? And what's the legal justification that the judge is using in this case?
Well, generically, in all cases, it's always a comparison or a balancing act between a client's right to a fair trial and even the state's right to a fair trial and the First Amendment and the public's right to an open trial and an open proceeding that anyone can look at. So if, in fact, you have a case that is so publicized that it might affect the ability for a fair trial, I can see a gag order in a generic case. But, you know, I've got to tell you, with the history that I have, that we were able to pick a jury in the George Zimmerman case, a case that had, you know, above and beyond any other cases as far as publicity, if we can get a jury in that case, even with no gag order in place, you have to wonder, is there any case out there that a gag order is appropriate for the idea or the concept of fair trial over an open trial?
Now Gerald has written a declaration, and he says, I take exception to the government's claim in their response that somehow it is in my best interest at heart, they have my best interest at heart in keeping my legal team muzzled and certain pleading secret. I believe the government has a profound conflict of interest in wanting to imprison me pre-trial without a hearing and without bail. I also personally object to any secret hearings, hearings by affidavit, and secret pleadings not made available to the public. So here's the defendant saying this. Why would a judge decide that this is all in his best interest if he doesn't want any of it?
You know, you would think that a client, a defendant, a citizen accused, has the most significant rights and needs to be protected. And if they are saying that they want to have an open hearing, they don't want anything closed, and they want the public involved, then even though the state has a concomitant right to a fair trial, it's the defendant's rights that still need to be protected. And what he's saying is, I want a public trial. I want to be able to look for witnesses. I want to be able to raise money if he wants to.
Yeah.
And that's the real concern. Again, we respect the court's ruling. It's in place where it is. But in a generic sense, just talking about gag orders generically, they are only supposed to be used as the exception to the rule. As a sort of quasi-member of the media now, I would take exception to any judge telling the media that you can't come into a courtroom and report on something, because the public has an absolute right to know. And quite honestly, I think it undermines the belief that people have, the trust that they're going to have in a system if they can't see it.
Yeah, well, we're going to follow this, Mark, and we'll have you back, and we'll also talk about this with other attorneys and have them weigh in on it. Very interesting. Finally, the brother of George Zimmerman did an Esquire magazine interview. He came out, he said he's gay. There were a lot of revelations. He made some news. What's your take on that whole thing? Should he have done that?
Well, you know, I feel for the Zimmerman family for everything that they've been through because of this event. I really do, and I feel for George as well. I just think that if they're going to make a public presentation, that it should be, you know, a sort of thought out and concise one, getting across the point that they want to get across. And I think, you know, some of what was in there about, you know, some get rich quick schemes and things like that.
And raiding the hotel, wet bar and all that stuff.
Yeah, I wasn't sure what the purpose of that was.
So bad decision, Mark, bad decision.
Overall, it could have been better written, better crafted.
All right, Mark O'Mara, we'll watch you on CNN, sir. Thank you.
Sounds great, Steve. Always good talking to you.
You too, sir. Bill Kristol's next.